Hi, it's so lovely to meet you. I've never had the pleasure before of speaking to you, so I'm super excited to get to know you.
Same here.
And I apologize for my voice. I have a bit of a cold, so I have a little bit of a sexy voice today.
Ah, nice.
I want to go straight into your next collection, which is called I Am My Own Mother, and
Yes.
you're showing it during Paris Fashion Week for the first time. Can you tell me a little bit about what you want to say with the story of this collection?
Well, basically, the whole idea of this collection started from this full moon rituals slash workshops that we have been doing. So this is something that started with the quarantine, actually. So every month during the full moon, we would do a wellness workshop, and that was where basically people would apply to be part of it. And I would personally lead them through a movement workshop where we were sort of talking about water and how that sort of affects, and it's very intrinsic in the way that we live our lives, and how the way that we perceive our bodily fluids is very telling of how we perceive water at large. So the idea that everything that is personal is also collective. So this sort of from microcosm to macrocosmos sort of thing, but it's this kind of need for a self-healing ritual. And the idea is that, the sort of love that you give to others, you're capable of giving to yourself. So it's all about self-nourishment, self-mothering, and so I guess I was just more inspired by the people who were taking part in the workshop, and also my experience in the workshop as well, because I take part as well. So I deal with my own issues as well. So yeah, it's this sort of healing.
Yeah, I understand that the full moon workshops were sold out. I mean that they've been a huge success. And so, go ahead, sorry.
We have done a few of them. So I try to do a lot, because I don't like to have a lot of people at once. So I have spaced them out. So we do it once or twice a month. But yeah, like now we're looking to expand on different workshops, and yeah.
It's an interesting concept to have something like that to part of your storytelling for a fashion brand, because I mean you were talking about the wetness and the importance of the fluids and how I know you've spoken about how people try to hide the different fluids of their bodies and that you really want to celebrate that and that's been your cornerstone, this kind of wetness look. Can you talk about where that in, the inspiration of that idea came from originally, what drew you to that form of expression, visual expression?
Well, basically, bodily fluids at large is something that I have been researching for many years, even before my master's. But because I have a background in performance art, this is what was my bachelor. But really, when I went to the master's, I really felt this that this was the time to look at how bodily fluids and our connection to the sea can also be something very deeply embodied in how we dress, and how the clothes that we wear can be a subtitle or a costume to our own performance. So yeah, this has sort of been also a personal healing journey for me, because I also had a lot of issues with the way that I was expressing myself, and more so in the sense that vulnerability is seen as something not strength.
Yeah.
So if you cry in public, you're not strong. If you're vulnerable, you're not strong. So it's this sort of very, sanitized
Yeah, it's
experience.
interesting that people think being in touch with your emotions is not a show of strength, that it's something to be, to be pushed aside or pushed down. I've been impressed by how you've been connecting with some big names within the industry, Kylie and Gigi Hadid, who of course was famously photographed in one of your dresses. For somebody who's just starting out, I mean, how many, is this your third season or is it, or am I
So
mistaken?
You know, because my shows haven't always been with Fashion Week. It's mm-hmm. kind of hard how you would define the season, but I guess, yeah, this is my third.
Yeah, it's like, a little fluid, let's say.
Yeah.
But but let's talk about were you able to reach out to these, you know, players, big players who have a huge network and following to kind of expand your message almost overnight to a certain extent?
Well, to be totally honest with you, because I get this question asked a lot, it just really happened very naturally. For example, with Gigi Hadid, her amazing stylist, Gabriella Carefa Johnson, she just, came into contact with me. And, you know, all of these things that we have done, it has sort of been that people have seen what we do and our message, and they just sort of come to us. So, yeah, I'm incredibly lucky. And
they feel a connection to the work that you're doing and are called to the collection. Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
And I understand, you said that your bachelor's was more movement and performance art, but you did grow up around, sewing, and yeah, I think your grandmother was a seamstress. So I just want to understand more the progression between the movement to the idea of expressing that in clothing in a way that maybe just, you know, movement and as an art form wasn't enough for you, that you wanted to do that.
Yeah, well, you know, I always had a very deep love for fashion and the idea of making clothes that you can actually wear and move in, and, you know, even the wet look, mm-hmm. even though that's a very, you know, sort of couture technique, it's mm-hmm. actually very movable. It's a very stretchy. It really fits, you know, your body, which that's something that's very important to me, that, you know, if you gain a couple pounds or lose a couple pounds, that things still fit.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, this sort of, you know, sensibility of fashion making that I really got from my grandma, because she was a seamstress and she was also a tailoring teacher.
Mm-hmm.
So it was all about making clothes that people can really move in. And, you know, that's really where I felt that performance art could be more this fashion practice, because you can be part of a performance if you see my brand more as a performance project,
mm-hmm.
but it's your experience, and that's what kind of makes it more performance art rather than theater, let's say, which is more you wear something for a show and then it's
yeah, and then it's all. But I mean, so, but what I find interesting about what's, you know, and lucky to a certain extent for you, is that as a performance artist and somebody who's, you know, knows how to communicate other than, let's say, you know, a fashion shows and clothing, when we're in this space that we're in with COVID and pandemics and confinement, that to express yourself via film is something that's quite natural for you. And yes. Can you talk about what this new film that you're going to be showing during Paris Fashion Week is about more specifically? I think I saw some images where the clothing is in velvets, if I'm not mistaken. Can you talk a little bit about your exploration as far as fabrics and the video itself?
Yeah. So basically, a lot with this workshop that we're doing, I was feeling a lot like I want something more warm and something I was very interested in sort of tactile sensibilities and how velvet feels very, to me, sort of safe.
Yeah, me too.
It has this sort of soothing quality to it. And even this thing that I'm wearing now, it's from the new collection. This also feels very, you know, soft and warm and sort of enveloping, kind of like a mother's hug or your own self hug.
Mm-hmm.
So this is sort of my material research. And every season I sort of do this. I look at materials and I'm thinking, okay, what do I want the wearer to feel mm-hmm. when they wear this? So yeah, it kind of goes very intuitive mm-hmm. in that sense.
And what made you decide to show during Paris Fashion Week? I know, like we talked about it, you did London in the past. Was it just a question of timing, or was there something about Paris that spoke to you?
Well, to be honest, it was a bit of both. Obviously, with Paris, you have a bit more time to develop a collection. And I did really want to give more time to myself and to the collection, the performers and everyone, but really I feel like I have a very deep connection with Paris. I feel like I have done a couple of my favorite shows. My actually first big show was in Paris with a stylist, Cristello Won and Isin. Mm-hmm. And it was really the first time that I felt very connected with the audience and with what I was doing. So I sort of, you know, emotionally, I always sort of go back to this place. Mm-hmm. And again, because this again is a very emotionally charged project for me, I really like the idea that I'm sort of going back to mm-hmm. this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, again, it sounds like returning, that, you know, you're talking about my, you know, I am my own mother, coming back to that place where you feel safe, creating pieces that are in fabrics that make you feel like you're being hugged by the fabrics, and yet have that sense of movement, not being confined by them. I think that's very telling about who you are as a person and who you are as a designer. Listen, it's been a pleasure speaking with you. I really look forward to seeing the collection. And I hope that when you're in Paris, that we can actually see each other in person and I'll be able to experience it in Charianos, as they say in French, in real life.
That'd be amazing. That'd be amazing.
Thank you so much for speaking to me. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it a lot.
Bye.